it might be just as tough a spot to be in. As to spot me in it. Yeah, this annual 5 mile apart game draws a crowd much bigger than solitary confinement. But that only magnifies the view from front and behind center. So let's size up to newbie QBs. Warrior sophomore Maurice Malloy enters his inaugural entanglement varsity-wise, despite this closest foe trying to give him the boot. Home opening night freshman Jamel Perry premieres here and hikes a mountain of a mission. Especially with that opposing pursue crew. Whichever first best fits his starting and starring role looms humongous over such an enormous sea arch rivalry. Team terms dictate the towering target as raising win one. Same situations, different pockets conceal youngins. But also reveal young guns. Duo delivering, ball out proof. On cue.
Let's go, be special.
Malloy marched his band 11 steps, covering 35 yards.
Go!
It was just not ready to play Keon Hall. Who altered the score with this sky-high, then bye-bye note. Jalen Malloy rerouted his Warriors right back onto the Dale side. The Knights' strip spikes flattened the Carriers' tires, however. So Cam Evans punted for a narrow second. Knightdale panted. Perry wasted no time loosening his cannon. Chasing Jason Dickerson. Throw so close. From fingertip to bungled snap, Jude Binion's invasion flip-flop fortunes. Sam Thomas's no-no net. Then Christian Sutton's rush ambush squashed that deepest threat yet.
And he's backed off a number eight, Christian Sutton.
From there, the Knights joined the Perry-go-round. It turned eight plugs and three Eastwake offsides infractions into 8 points. The drive highlights waited until the second quarter.
Hey, we're killing ourselves! Watch the ball!
When the rookie got cooking to Dwayne Lee. Then a magic bullseye to Khalil Sanders. Then this. The degree of difficulty was off the charts immediately. Jason Dickerson, a gain alone to the zone. What a combustible combo nanza. Perry's on call number equal to more. If it seems like we've reached that Warrior fadeaway moment, well, maybe an introduction is in order. A la the Winborn identity. Senior Zamarion Winborn burned holes through the defense for 36 yards along six stabs. Following a major night penalty, plus a Mo Malloy ahoy to Zevin Tooks, who took the hit and made the catch. To one. Winborn went inbound and on board. Wasn't crazy to believe the tide would swing occupant direction. Except Carson Lee deflected more Perry persuasion. Aaron Slade pinned the enemy The Knight Resistance stymied Winborn and Malloy airborne. Perry's problem ought to been time. Or the lack thereof. Even with no room to roam, blurred reality and tagged Chris Hart's cling out of thin air. Leaving just enough ticks to explode his next exploit. A nick of time dime for Toe Good, Toe Be True Dickerson. Instant classic. But count it? Was Perry past scrimmage? Clearly the 31. Before he triggered. Looks like he began motion and launched legally. Because any inch of his body just needed to be at the mark. Separate angles, separated emotions. A somber walk-off versus a festive dance-off. Jason Slickerson also provided a boost on his ensuing touch. While the guest refused to budge. They blinked. Allowing Thaddeus Edwards to recover his forces forward flow. Perry hooked Dwayne Lee. And tucked for a strike trip. Just short is how the could-have-been crippling blow landed due to East Wake's gigantic stand. Plus Binion's anchor drop and Cam Evans' retaliatory pop stop. Disaster averted, danger inherited. When there was no quick flight fix, the Warrior O spent 14 plows digging dirt and churning field. Mostly relying on its lone mower. Cutting all 99 yards. As well as the lead to six after Win Born bored through. And Evans invited the extra to the party.
This is good. So, with 30 seconds left in the third quarter.
Thus, the Warriors injected worry into this warring. Oh! inspiring a night fourth quarter crusade which lasted 11 cracks and almost 5 minutes. Undaunted by a trick which vanished under an ineligible receiver flag. Precious progress also cost the Castle Dwellers a couple of key contributors. Including Perry after maybe his finest hour yet. Roughing penalty removed him from the equation. However, that number two option is one bad dude. Juke and Dickerson spearheaded an impale trail to the doorstep. Where official ruling denied this pylon pat. There, Coach Travis Harrison fortified his warrior stone wall, which didn't dent. Protecting a late chance for a recent history twist. Only if East Wake could repeat earlier glory and go the entire gridiron distance.
Oh,
an illegal contact against Knightdale bailed them out of jail on 3rd and 10. Mo Malloy accumulated 130 all-purpose clicks, none more important than these 12 to keep hope alive. Dwayne Lee's PBU. And Jaden Dixon's DDT helped put the Dream in the ICU. Malloy seemed to know CPR. Because he resuscitated a code red, evading the compression for a long pump to safety valve Michael Perry. The flat line occurred at the laundry toss. Block in the back. Did you ID it amid the mayhem? The 4th and 15 also ended Chris disheartening.
The pass is incomplete.
Chain move provoked the clock drain groove. The Knights maintained their amore with series victories intact since 2015. But the current status quo faces an advancing adversary not about to concede anything easy any longer. Heck of a win. Proud of you. Hey, we continue to streak, right? Continue to streak. That was our goal tonight. Okay, go 1-0 this week. We went 1-0 this week. Feel good about it. It's great to stand there at the end, get off the field. You're about to give me a heart attack. We got BD there, but hey, y'all got it done. Got it done, okay? Come on, you guys did a great job up front. We got to get better. Everything's got to get better, though, if we want to play high-level football. Y'all understand that?
Hey, family on three. 1, 2, 3.
Family! On a hot night, though, hot nights release some steam. Because survival is the law of the 64 asphalt jungle. I'm Don Fuller, Eastwake Television.